Hello everybody, and hello people coming in. I'll try and speak nice and manly. It seems like most of you know what's going on. This is live RPG Plus. We are going to play a game of Pathfinder for approximately, you know, sort of however many minutes is left. It's going to be thick, it's going to be faster, and you all are going to have quite a lot of control about what happens. You need to have your thinking caps on, your crazy ideas. We're going to keep it vaguely 15 plus MC PG G rated. Oh! Is there in fact anyone who's 12 or less in the audience? Excellent. All you have to do is have some fun. This is absolutely by a long way my favourite game of the year, and it's very exciting to have some fun guests with us this year. I am Benjamin Looms. I'm the guy who made the Syrinscape theme, which you can see up there. It makes incredibly beautiful immersive music for tabletop gaming. It's really easy to use. And it basically fixed my problem of trying to run YouTube videos and having an ad come in halfway advertising cars or something. It's really awesome. Derek and I are also Dicestormers, and you might check out our YouTube channel where we don't take role playing very seriously and get quite a lot of flame wars on the comments.
Excellent. At the time, I suggested that a cat could climb a rope.
Wow. Yes. Fantastic. Introduce each of you in line.
Me first?
Yes.
Yes, so my name is Derek Proud. I'm a game designer and game producer. I have my own company called Guru Games. We have our first game out called Loco Loco. I've been playing role-playing games all my life and love doing it on our YouTube channel and love coming and doing it with you guys.
I think that's illegal on YouTube,
isn't
it? Excellent.
Special,
and then two fantastic guests, poor Nathan, who was down to come and play with us today. It's really sick, basically, as of a couple of days ago, couldn't come. So we have two additional guests today, which is very exciting.
Hello, I'm Morgan Jenkins, and I didn't poison candy, just to put that out there right now.
Right.
Not my fault.
Allegedly.
Exactly, yeah. The alleged men in the water of the show. No. I have a podcast called Going in Blind, where a group of vision impaired players actually sit down and play Dungeons and Dragons. And we use it mostly to deal with Kat's aggression. She's terrifying. One of the players, she made necklaces out of everything in the game. So, we've got about 10 episodes exist, and then we had to go on hiatus because someone burnt down a village again. Couldn't tell you who, and I had to go tear down what was left. True story. We're coming back soon with more episodes, more murder from Kat.
Definitely worth a check out. Really fascinating and cool.
My name is Jessica Hutchinson, and I am an actor and writer. I currently contribute to Geek Girl Authority, and I've been helping Ben with Syrinscape now for the last, 2 or 3 years or something. We go to GenCon together and have an amazing time harassing Americans. But I will say, it's been a little while since I've roleplayed, so be nice.
No.
We should probably get a flavour for the political aspirations of the room. Red for Trump, green for Hillary. And a couple of donkey votes.
All right.
See someone hold a burning torch.
The players are going to now introduce their characters, which they have thought up. The characters have a class. And a bit of a name and a bit of backstory, but they each need a trait which you would contribute, please. We will do, each year we've sort of done this and it's become more and more, less plausible, but basically calling out is really great. And I will eventually point at someone in random, apparently having heard a great idea, and that person will actually get to contribute the idea. So we'll do that. And, a trait for the character, and then something they're going to be wearing. Ooh. Something unique about their costume. Has always said that quite well. So Derek, who are you playing?
I am playing a sorcerer. We're all level 7, is that right?
You are all level 7.
Quite powerful.
Yeah, yeah.
And my name is Prances with Werewolves. just Pranny for sure. Yes, female human sorceress. I have fairly sort of wild tribal hair and a bunch of tattoos that glow and sparkle when I cast spells that just sort of light up. And I've got really great toe nail polish.
Excellent. Republican, fantastic. What is Francis wearing?
Live cat. Destroyed my town, and I didn't drown. I couldn't seem to die.
We could fix that today if you'd like.
I found a sword, so to speak, while I was plowing a field, so to speak. I named it Patrice, and I tried to use that doing all the farm work, trying to rebuild, and I just kept using the sword for everything, until eventually my parents just kicked me out of the house after the incident involving milking going wrong. forced to basically just go out on an adventure like my much older and much more handsome brother.
Fantastic. Excellent. That's very moving. Almost completely irrelevant to all of this. Excellent. We have the blue shirt there up at the back. Have we got somewhere around there, say, a quirk? That makes sense. Let's go with that.
Fear of water.
Yeah.
Right. Can it be terror?
Horror.
Terror of water.
Terror. Yeah.
Does that include Skittle?
Mine.
Steve.
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 Steve. lined up there on stage. Alexander Steddington, who's there with his two swords, multiple Steddingtons. We have Elizabeth the Barbarian wearing the...
That's Elizabeth Kensington Pompenhausen Smythe the Third.
Excellent, good. And the cleric, Dirty Mike. Now last year everyone made me do a Scottish accent, so I'm not going to do that again. I'm not going to ask you.
Irish!
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 Irish! Irish!
Irish!
Irish!
Irish!
Irish!
What's the DC on wearing a goat?
Depends on the skill.
Well,
20.
I just realised that I'm terrified of water, and one of my best skills is swimming. I got 11 plus what? What would we go with? Ride! 11 plus...
Ride!
11 plus 12.
Do you mount the goat?
Well, the goat rides you.
The goat rides you.
The goat
rides you. So it's a ride check. Yes, yeah, for the goat. Fantastic. Well, for us to speak out into dream up goats type of bandages, so I mean, goat dash. So what was Irish, wasn't I? Recording me always with Irish, isn't it? All right. What is the charge for Elizabeth?
Wearing Crocs! Wearing Crocs!
Yeah,
walking. Wearing white after Labor Day!
When one is a barbarian, one does not have to answer to other people's fashion statements.
Obviously, I'm Crocs.
You I think you've turned the jury against you. Oh. All right, just a punishment from over there. You have to die in the white outfit with the blood of the goat.
Over my class.
What skills can you use to die?
Craft.
Intelligence based. What's your intelligence value?
Average.
Excellent. DC 15, let's say. And you've got no bonus at all. Excellent.
14.
14. Oh, she succeeds! Yay! Well done.
Out of all the punishments, you had making a jacket look lovely, a nice bit of fur, and death.
Just, I think the punishments got more imaginative.
That's right. No, we need to say the oath of absolute future passiveness. Passivity? That's a word. So everyone repeat after me in the room. I promise.
I promise!
To no longer kill the thing!
To no longer kill the thing!
And not take all the gold all the time!
And not take all the gold all the time!
Especially if it's an NPC the Game Master is trying to talk to you with!
Especially if it's an NPC the Game Master is trying to talk to you with!
Close to
green for the audience and red for the cultists. Green for the audience and red.
11.
11, ooh.
11's on this guy. Is he not damaged at all?
Right, yes, he's damaged badly. Three magic missiles. No damage. The guy going, yay! Well, the guy going, yay! Okay, 5 points left.
Right.
Stellington, your chance to flee.
Redeem yourself.
Yes.
Mike!
Right, what should Mike do? Mike's standing here.
Values.
strange.
This is just like that dream I had!
Excellent, and an eye attack for Jess's character.
Bees!
A massive swarm of bees comes flying out of the spectator's eyes. DC 15 reflex save to leap out of the way of the bees. And how have you been rolling so far? I think you succeed.
I'm good, huh?
I'm allowed to laugh because I got a one.
What damage does a swarm of bees do against Jessica?
Oh,
okay.
I'm winning.
No,
I'm
Seduction check.
Seduction check?
Yes,
And I'm on Syrinscape on one of the sound sets, on one of the taverns.
Yes.
I'm several drunk people. With a fantastic song about whiskey drinking called Whoops My Mouth.
It takes on a new irony, doesn't it? Follow Jess on Twitter.
Yeah, you can follow me on Twitter at Rarely Updated. It's a
Rarely Updated
kind of name. And you can also catch my writing on Geek Girl Authority at the moment, where I am currently going through Mad Men. I've never watched it before, and I'm watching it drunk.